In 2007, the Dirac Medal was awarded to John Ilio Poulos for his work on the physics of the charm quark, a major contribution of the birth of the standard model and the modern theory of elementary particles.
So, thank you very much for the introduction. And please, once more, because I am an old teacher, and being introduced by a young student is extremely nice, and I thank you very much. In fact, I will not talk about the work for which I was awarded the Dirac Medal, although I will make some. You can find the details in every book, so it's not important. I will rather talk to you, and I will tell you, first of all, that I envy you a lot. Well, this is hardly surprising. You are young and I'm not, so it's normally. But on top of that, I envy you because you enter physics in a period where I will try to argue it will be extremely exciting. So I wish I were young again to join the fun which is going to come in the years ahead. I hope that I will watch it, but I won't be able to join the fun. So this is the... So, as I said, the title is New Physics at the LHC. This way it goes, right, I guess. No. No. Yes, this is the advance. But it doesn't advance. How does it advance? No. I think this is simpler, yeah, okay. So, the point I want to make is that precision measurements at one energy scale allow us to guess new physics at the next scale. And, well, there are various examples. The first and most well-known example, of course, is Yukawa, when he predicted the existence of the pi meson at a time when pi meson was not discovered. Right? There were no accelerators to produce it, and nobody had looked carefully at cosmic rays at that time to discover pi mesons. But he guessed the existence of this particle by studying the energy levels, the nuclear forces that were known. In fact, it's funny to see that in this case, the physics was accurate, although the details were not. In his first paper, Yukawa did not write the Yukawa interaction we call today Yukawa interaction, right? It did the second paper. So the second example is what you said, is the absence with high accuracy of strangeness changing neutral current transitions, and the smallness of the K1, K2 mass difference allowed us to make the prediction of the charm particle, again at a time when there were no such predictions. So I claim that in the same way, new physics is predicted for LHC, and we are about to discover that new physics. So first of all, this is, well, a picture that we all know. That's where LHC is. Let me give you some very fresh data from LHC. Had a very good start at half the energy, square root of S7 TeV. Maximum peak luminosity already reached was 2×10^32, better than was expected this year. The design luminosity, I remind you, was 10^34, so eventually it will go like that. Experiments gathered an integrated luminosity of 40 inverse picobarns for the moment. Just again, to give you the set the scales, if you want to discover Higgs, for example, which is one of the goals, you need 10 inverse femtobarns, so you are far away yet, right, at 14 TeV. I will come back to what we've been discovering in a moment. They have already 348 bunches per per bean. The design value is 2,800 or something. But this is almost why they don't put more, is that for the moment bunches are well separated. They have a separation of 150 nanoseconds, and the designed value is 25 nanoseconds. So if you squeeze them, you can put more bunches, and that's how you can increase, of course, luminosity. And the good news is that the detectors work absolutely marvelously, which is was surprising because they are extremely complex detectors, and they have an extremely good photon resolution. The separation between photons and pi zeros, the main background for photons is pi zeros that decay into photons, and the separation is better than 70%. They have a very good separation. And these are good news because the Higgs, eventually, you will, if it is a low mass Higgs, you will determine it by its two photon decay. So you better know what you are talking about when you talk about photons. And these people claim they know what they are talking about. Photons. Okay. Here is a plot. This is the delivered LHC, delivered luminosity, and ATLAS recorded. And you see that the experiments work beautifully. They record practically all the luminosity that is provided by the machine. It's really very, very pretty. Today, the proton-proton run has stopped, and they started the ion-ion collisions. In fact, the first ion-ion collision, lead-lead collision, was detected in the night between the 6th and 7th of November, just a few days ago. So it's really very fresh news. They expect to start back on proton-proton in March 2011. They will have a small shutdown for Christmas, but then they will just start again. They will try to increase the energy from 7 up to 9 TeV. The exact value will be known probably beginning 2011. There is a workshop, the Chamonix workshop. Those of you who are interested in the details of the experiments are welcome to go there. The luminosity will increase, and they expect to go up to 7 × 10^32, which is a fact more than a factor of 3 of what is now. And this will be done in 3 ways. First, because they will increase the number of bunches. The inter-bunch ratio will go down to 50 nanoseconds. It's 150 now. This gives almost a factor of 3. They will probably decrease beta star. The beta star is the transverse dimension of the beam. And of course, the more you squeeze the beam, the more luminosity you get, right? And also in this little going up from 7 to 9 TeV if they succeed in doing that. It will be decided beginning 2011, probably again at the Chamonix workshop, if the LHC, initially LHC was supposed to stop operating the end of 2011 and have a long 1 year shutdown to improve the connections between the magnets. The problem they had is that one of the electrical connections, a trivial problem, a very, very simple, trivial problem, electrical connection that was not well done. And since there are 250,000 connections like that, try to do them all again. It takes time because you have to warm up the machine. The machine is cold and all that, and it takes time. So it will take a year. But because LHC is working so well, even at lower energies, they may decide to run for another year, not only 2011, but also 2012, and let the shutdown and the increase in energy for later. Of course, you understand that the background over that is the competition with Fermilab, which is also working very beautifully and has, yeah. So this is it will be decided soon. So Then again, eventually they will have a long 3-4 year run at the maximum energy and probably maximum luminosity. So here is an event. Most of the events, this is to show you how the vertex detectors work beautifully. This is, most of the events have more than one proton-proton collision per recorded event. When you record, you have many proton-proton collisions. Here is one with four. If you look, you can see that there are four collisions, four collision points, which shows that the vertex detector, and this is better than 200 microns, the resolution of the in the points. You see how beautifully the vertex detectors work. You can really see four collisions in this picture. It's absolutely amazing how they do it. Oh, this is another beautiful result. This is the, I will only show two results like that. This is the cross-section for the W production. And you see this is Fermilab, VP bar, and this is P. These are theoretical curves for various channels. And it's what people call next-to-next-to leading order QCD, which is means extremely complicated computations, QCD computations, to compute the background. You see, in fact, the discovery at LHC means really controlling the background. That's what it means. LHC is an extremely dirty machine that will produce junk and junk all over the place, and you have to dig the signal you want out of that junk, which means that you must control the background extremely well. And this tells you how well these people are able to compute the background, the theorists. And these are the data. These are the ATLAS data, right? And you see also that by that energy, the advantage of having PP bar relatively to PP practically disappears, because then the gluons become more important, and then you forget about that. So this is the W, and these are the Z results. Again, very beautiful results, very beautiful calculations.